kitchen with an oven and a stove.
Hey, welcome to Nick's Supper Club, everybody, and welcome as always to my home. Tonight we have a very special evening, as we always do. We are gonna we're gonna live up to our mantra, which is friends, food, and song. Clearly, I have my friends here. The food's in the house, and the song later is gonna be the song "Drift Away," originally done by Dobie Gray. Tonight we're gonna have moussaka, which is a Greek dish. Moussaka is kind of like Greek lasagna, or maybe Greek shepherd's pie. It has eggplant and potato and meat. And it's all spiced up nice, and a bechamel sauce. And I can't figure out for the life of me where the Greeks got the bechamel sauce. It's a French thing. Anyway, the Greeks would argue they came up with it first. We're gonna have some baba ganoush, which is kind of from Lebanon. It's basically a Mediterranean thing this evening. Anyway, thanks so much for being here tonight. Salute. Let's have a blast, everybody. Okay, here we go. We're gonna start our culinary adventure. A couple of our dishes this evening feature this guy. This is an eggplant. I've been practicing that all day. So this is an eggplant, and this eggplant, known in Italian as a melanzana, and in Greece they call it a melitzana. Those guys say everything different. Anyway, we made a couple of dishes with this tonight. One of them is moussaka, which is a Greek dish, and the other one is baba ganoush. That's this one right here. Essentially, you know, I can't get everything in on the show, and I can't show how to cook everything, but the recipe for this, actually the recipe for everything here, is on nicksupperclub.com. You can get all the recipes, they're fantastic. Cook them over and over again, share with your friends. This is baba ganoush. What that is basically is I take three of these guys, I cut them in half, I bake them in the oven, I bake them until they're soft and cooked, I scoop out all the flesh on the inside, I puree it, I add tahini. Those of you who don't know what tahini is, it is basically sesame paste. I add tahini, I add some lemon juice, I add some salt, pepper, and of course garlic. This one over here, this is called hummus. Hummus is not made with eggplant, but we're gonna feature it today anyways because this is all about the Mediterranean. The hummus is made with chickpeas, and that has also tahini and garlic and lemon, salt, pepper, and a little bit of lemon rind. That's my wife Julie's special recipe, and that is also on the website. The other thing we're going to do tonight, and this is the main dish, is our moussaka. Essentially, the moussaka is eggplant. It's layered like a lasagna. It's eggplant, it's potato, it is ground beef that's been seasoned and fried, and then is a layer of bechamel sauce over the top. So what happens is we take the eggplant, we peel it, and then we cut it into quarter-inch slices, long, and then we brine it, which means we put it in some water with salt and we let it soak for about a half hour. And what happens is that pulls all of the bitterness out of the eggplant. And then you dump that off, you take the eggplant out of the water, and then you lay it out on paper towels and you pat it, you push it down and kind of try to absorb some of the water, that's the moisture that's in the eggplant. Another one of the things that's in the layer is potatoes. And all we did was we took a regular potato, sliced it into about quarter inch pieces, and fried it in canola oil until they became like chips, you know, but they're not crispy chips. They're chips that, you know, you can break it, but it's cooked through. This is gonna be part of one of those layers as well. The next step after this is all done, it's cooked, it's ready to go. The next thing I need to do is I need to saute the ground beef with onions, garlic, etc. And we're gonna do that in a few minutes. We'll be right back at you.
Day after day, I'm more confused. Look for the light in the pouring rain. You know that's a game that I had to lose. In the strain, ain't a shame. Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away. Give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away.
Okay, here we go. Now we're gonna make the ground beef that's gonna go in the moussaka, and the meat is spiced so nice. It's got cinnamon and nutmeg, oregano, it's delicious, garlic, onion naturally, all those kind of things. So we're gonna start it off. I put some olive oil in the pan. There's about 4 tablespoons in there. And we're gonna turn the heat up. And the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fry some onions. And I'm gonna let the onions fry for a minute or two. I'm gonna let them fry for a minute or two before I add the garlic. Typically, if you're frying onions and garlic, you wanna fry the onion first because it has more water, so it takes a little longer for it to cook down. So if you put them both in at the same time, your garlic can end up burning before your onions are even done. So we're just gonna get this pan hot. I'm gonna throw in the onions. My favorite part of the day, on any day really, is the sound of anything hitting oil, because it crackles and makes this awesome sound, and it always smells great.
Bubbling,
we got it going on. Here we go. Okay. And there it is. Off we go, we're going to the races. So what's gonna happen is we're gonna let that cook for a minute before we throw in the garlic. Okay, next in's gonna go the garlic. We can do that. It's time. Let that cook for another minute. Really does, doesn't it?
Always my favorite part of cooking, right here.
Yeah, right?
It's so true.
Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put in the meat. We got 4 pounds of ground beef. Here it goes. Ah. Now it starts to get interesting. All right, we're almost there. Okay, so this is what's gonna happen next. I'm glad you asked. Patty's gonna put in the cinnamon. And give it a little mix around there, kiddo. All right, and then you can feel free to stir around a bit.
All right.
I'm gonna hang out with you, let her do some work. My arm was getting tired. It does, right? Isn't it amazing? This is like kick-ass sloppy Joe.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, now here, why don't you put the nutmeg in? Nutmeg is Rebecca's favorite.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, you know what? You can. I should have, and I apologize.
Okay.
Let her have a shot at it. Let's put the salt and the oregano in there. Yeah, jump in there, kiddo. Her arm's getting tired, I can see. It's a little taxing. There you go, oregano too. Yeah, throw it all in there. Give it a little stir, and then we'll throw the tomato paste in. All right, here we go. We're gonna put in the tomato paste. The thing that I like to do to this, and I won't do it until after we put it in with the rest of the moussaka, I put a little bit of, you could put it in now, I guess, but I put it on top of it. I put like lemon rind. Okay, now we're gonna throw a little fresh parsley in there. This is about 4 or 5 tablespoons. It does, right? It's beautiful. All right. Yeah, I think it's pretty much done. Now we're gonna start to assemble our moussaka. We'll be right back at you. Okay, now's the time where we have to assemble the moussaka. Now, the way this works is we're basically gonna layer things, a layer of eggplant, a layer of potato, a layer of meat, and then a layer of eggplant. And then after that, we still have to make a bechamel sauce that goes over the top. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna layer the eggplant. It's very simple, we've already cooked it. We're just gonna take it and layer it in, just like this. Just lay it along the side so you get it nice and tight on the edges. And now I'm gonna have my friend, Barbara, take over and start doing the layering. So just do one layer.
Okay.
Of eggplant.
Okay.
And then we're gonna do potato. I'll do the little first couple of potatoes and then you do the rest.
Okay.
All right, you cool with that?
Yes.
Now my hands are all greasy. What am I gonna do?
Wash them.
Did you wash your hands?
I did.
I knew you did. I'm teasing you. Fantastic.
There's one and one more.
Perfect.
There you go.
Perfect.
Yep.
Good job.
Fabulous. Beautiful. Okay, nice job. All right, so next thing is we're gonna layer some potatoes in there. I don't know. Who wants to do the potatoes? You going to jump in? All right, Sam. Sam is in our house band tonight. Layer the potato. All total, this was 6 eggplant and 5 potatoes.
How'd you cook the potatoes? Did you fry them?
Yep, they were fried. It's very important when you fry them too, when you take them out of the oil, to not let them sit on top of each other, put them on paper and drizzle a little bit of salt. There you go.
Beautiful.
Fantastic. Voila. Beautiful. Now the next thing that's going to happen is we're going to put in a layer of meat. Let's just dump this right over into here.
Don't skip on the meat, Nick.
I will not.
It smells so good.
Right?
It's still hot.
Oh, yeah. Okay. We're getting there.
And whether you like it or not.
Okay. There's one more thing I'm going to add to this. And that is, I like a little bit of lemon zest in it. So we're gonna just do a little lemon zest here.
Ooh, yum, I love lemon. Me too.
Sam?
Yeah.
Do I got it covered?
I don't know, there's a lot of holes.
There's a lot of holes.
You know, that's the problem with being an artist.
But it looks nice.
You can do that.
It does look nice.
All right, we'll run with that. That's good enough for me. Now, the one more thing we gotta do is then now a layer. Well, you can eat. I'm gonna put the cheese on now. Cheese. You ready?
Am I ready?
Yeah. Put the cheese on it.
What kind of cheese?
This is Parmesan cheese. There is a Greek substitute. The name escapes me at the moment, but I've been told it tastes just like Parmesan, so that's what I'm using. And you just spread that nice and evenly. Totally.
Especially when the
bechamel. Gluten free, right?
Yes. All around, nice, nice. Okay, now another layer of eggplant, and then after that the bechamel goes on. So who wants to do the layer of eggplant with no holes?
I think the birthday.
I don't mind doing that. Yes. You know, I want to say this is my friend Miles' birthday right now today. 55 years old.
Thank you.
Okay, now final touch to the moussaka is, you know, I keep saying moussaka, that's the way the Greeks would say it. When you grow up in Norwood, Mass, you say moussaka. Anyway, we're making moussaka, and that's the way it's supposed to be pronounced. So I'm gonna try to run with that, even though I keep falling back into my Massachusetts accent. So what happens is we're gonna make what's called a roux. This is part of the whole French thing, which I was a little bit confused about. Because in French cooking, there's 5 mother sauces, and one of them is called a bechamel. And you start that by having a roux. A roux is melted butter and then a little bit of flour. So what's gonna happen is, I already melted the butter a little bit. We're gonna put some flour in here. There's 2 cups of flour, 2 sticks, it's basically equal parts of equal parts butter flour. I'm gonna put this in here a little bit. I'm gonna start mixing it around. I'm gonna put a little more, and we're gonna mix it around and try to get a nice, even, smooth roux. And there it is. We got a little heat going. We're gonna let that cook for a second. Now, what I've done in the meantime is I've heated up some milk, because milk is the next big ingredient to make a bechamel sauce. And in this particular situation with the moussaka, you also have some eggs. You have 6 egg yolks all by themselves, hanging out. And here they are. What's gonna happen is, I'm gonna put a little bit of that milk into this egg yolk. And the reason is, I'm gonna put a little in now because I need to temper those eggs. Because if I just start throwing those eggs in to something hot, they're gonna just scramble immediately. And that's not what we want. So I took a little bit of that hot milk right here. I'm gonna pour it in real quick, and then I'm gonna quickly grab that whisk. Let's see if I can do it all at once. There we go, it's in, eggs not scrambling. Oh yeah, here we go. So, our eggs are now tempered. All right, so we got this. What's gonna happen now is, we got this roux going, the milk's going in. Let's throw a little more of that in there for a moment. Let's get that mixed in. And what the objective here is to get a really thick, see how it's thickening already? Now we're gonna put some more milk in there. Let's throw it all in. And here we go. Alrighty, now we're gonna put in our eggs. Let's not waste anything. Okay, now we're gonna put in a teaspoon of nutmeg, a couple teaspoons of salt. There we go. This is gonna happen pretty quick, but you know, you gotta have a strong arm for this. So I'm gonna have my friend Keely jump in there, but you gotta go fast. And it's gonna keep thickening and thickening and thickening. It's gonna happen pretty quick though. Get in there, go. Right on.
Nick, I appreciate that you clean as you go.
I do. I can't do the messy kitchen thing.
Uh-oh.
How are you making out there, girlfriend?
Fabulous.
Oh, look at her go. I can just turn it off. I'm gonna turn the heat off. You can keep mixing. Yeah, it's ready, man. Okay, we have now achieved a successful bechamel. Look how thick and beautiful that is.
That was delicious.
Don't you just want to bathe in it?
I do. Really do.
I do. So right, well now I just gotta take it, pour it over the moussaka, the layers we made with the eggplant, the potato, the beef, and then eggplant again. This goes over the top and then we bake it in the oven. Here we go. This is my favorite, watch this. Let's see.
Oh my
God. Whoa.
Oh.
Isn't that insane? And there's a bunch still in there. I gotta like get a spatula in. I was telling Nick earlier that this is where like mac and cheese comes from.
Yes.
You just put a bunch of cheese in this and then mix it with macaroni. Good Lord. All right, there it is. Now we're just gonna even it out. Beautiful.
That looks fattening.
It's very fattening.
Oh yeah. Before it was diet.
He lied. I have a tendency to do that. Okay, so now it goes in the oven.
Yep.
Here we go. Yep, that's okay. I can put it on top and then open it.
Got it.
Oops, sorry, sweetie. Woo! There we go. Oven is set at 400 degrees. And it's gonna bake for about 40 minutes. What you're looking for is you're looking for the top of that bechamel to get a nice golden brown sort of crust on the top. And then you can cut it up and eat it. It's delicious. All right, here we go. The moment we've been waiting for, the moussaka. Oh, here it comes. As promised, golden brown. Look at that baby. Woo-hoo! Look at that thing. Now we're gonna. We're gonna let that rest for a little bit and then we're gonna cut into it and serve it up.
Nice.
Coming back at you. All right, so now all we have to do is we have to kind of cut around the edge. It's ready, I can tell. We're going around the edges. I will not. I'm like a sturgeon. Let's go center. All right, I'm gonna start plating it up. I wasn't even counting as I was doing it. I just did it.
You know what? That looks delicious. That looks awesome.
Okay, now. Right, here we go. Now let's make it look pretty. And that's a little bit of salt and lemon rind. Come on, folks, take your place. Don't be shy.
you've given me. I want you to know I believe in your song.
Thanks so much for being here tonight at Nick's Supper Club. As promised, we have conquered this eggplant by making some fantastic Mediterranean food. We had so much fun. Did you guys have fun?
Yeah!
All right. We had food, we had song, and we have friends. Salute, everybody.